Michael Cassidy. Glad you're with us today. We're going to do this haircut. I've done her hair twice on video. And I'm going to do it the third time here. But what's happened, she's got tired of it and got aggravated with it, got long on her. So she run a clipper up. And I've had some of my best haircuts when people actually kind of gapped the hair up and got it to the length that I needed it. And I can actually change it and come in and do a nice style on it. So we still got something to work with, and I think we're going to come in with a good style. And a lot of people cut the hair and almost get it to the length that they want it. And I can just work in there and just shape it right up. So she's not ruined it. She might have thought she did, but she really just got it to the place where I can work with it some. And I don't have to ask her, can I cut that style, because she's already kind of got it. So I'm going to start out with a 3/8 blade right here at the bottom. Fade this in. I'd have to talk her into this cut I'd like to give her. So it's already about there. So what we're going to do is come in here and shape it up a little. Got a real pretty color hair, color lid. That's your natural, and this is what you colored it. So, that is natural at the bottom, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Start with that. I'm going to go ahead and take a, try my 3/4 blade on it, right here on the sides. See what we can do here with this. See if we can. Kind of get this out of the way a little bit and see what we can do. Put it here. Bring it in right here like this. You'll notice this is the way I'm fading right in here. Back into this. Come right here and do the same thing now. And you notice it'll be right through here. You notice what I'm doing. I've actually got to angle down a little there. Thought she'd ruined her hair, but she just really got it set up for a nice style. That's what it boils down to. Now, there was one woman named Ann that used to come in all the time. Ann, I ain't gonna call last name. Another one. And, she did that a lot. She'd cut her hair up and just chop it all up. But she'd bring it up high, but it was just right. I could just put it right in style. She almost had the style like she wanted it. And I'd work on it 15 to 20 minutes, and I'd really have it looking right, because she put it about the length I needed it for that style. So I hear somebody come to the door. Come down here with a 3/8 blade now, right here. Now, get that right around here a little bit. It's just to kind of get it out evenly and level. Then I'll come back in and blend with my comb to make sure it blends and fades. I'm not necessarily finishing. I'm just bringing it down to what I need. Then I'm gonna finish it with the comb right there. There you go. Just leave that nice look on that sideburn pointed slightly. A little more blending on that. That's not finished. Okay. Things up on there pretty good. Maybe we can get that to look like we want it to look. We got to blend it, so let's work in here a little bit. Get there. Make this blend right in here a little bit. So when I finish the bottom, I'm notorious for going back over it again to make sure I got it, because I know that I really don't have this right. I'm just kind of getting it close to it. But it's close to being. I got to come in and put this hairline in at the bottom. But we're getting there with it. Just got to, I like going back over it again. What I need to do now is dry this. I'm going to dry it right quick. Dry this and see what we got. If I can dry this thing and get it laying right when it's dry, get it blended, it's going to look right. I don't know how people just let somebody walk out with a wet head at a styling shop or a barber shop, because you never really can get it right until you dry it. I can't. I don't know how they can, but I'm not able to until I really get it dry and do my finishing touches. That always makes a difference in a hairstyle. We got a little cowlick or tough here or something. But no problem, when you put a little hairspray product on it, it's gonna be okay. I do it with a comb okay, but if I can ever get my clipper back in it, then I can tell that it's perfect. It'll pretty much perfect. So if there's anything such as a perfect haircut, you can do it with a clipper, a guard if you're using it. If you got the length, you do that. We knew that it probably would end up being just a little spiky back here at the back. But I think that's what's really going to give us a nice look on this cut. You see what I'm doing with the clipper, actually making a perfect, more perfect cut with it. But I don't want to get it too short. I want to make sure I get into the right angle here with the scissors, between the scissors and the clipper. So I can run it, this 1-inch blade, this way and that way. There's no way I can cut it that smooth with my comb and scissors, shears. There's no way I can do it. Possible. You'll make it a complete 1-inch and make it that smooth. Without 2 or 3 times as much work, you won't get the same results even then. So, okay. Let me fall back down with my 3/4 blade now to the right point here where it actually comes off the head at. I like this because it's kind of creating something a little different and new for you. It's kind of exciting a little bit to see this, just something a little different. What I should do is letting it come down to the length of the bang here. We've got to get a little bit here. I'm actually going to leave this a lot fuller here. Blend in here. So, it's making a difference. Come here, finagle with it just a little bit. You've been one of my top models. People really look at your haircut too. That's I sure appreciate you letting me cut your hair on video. Grab my little 3/4 blade again now, and I can actually bring it in a little better now with this. You're missing it if you don't use your guards on these short haircuts. You're missing it because you're going to cut your time in half on these cuts. Okay, now I'm going to come down to my, well, I need a half inch blade. Let me go get it. Okay, it's gonna make the difference. So what I'm doing is find that where it falls off, comes off the head at. If I do that, I can't go wrong on this cut. It's gonna fade, it's gonna blend, it's gonna look good. Okay, it's falling back down into a 3/8 blade at the bottom, what I'm going back down to. Let me get my 3/8 blade here. Put it right in right here. A little. I've noticed if you get this done, then you can fall back and get that. And if to really make this top look right, I've got to get this hairline completed. Get my nice design here cut in, the nice angled in point. If I do that, I'll be okay as far as finishing the cut. Like I say, if I can get this looking right here, get it just right, and get it right here, then I can come back and I can finish this cut. and bring it in. Having trouble. It was a little bit high right there. It's blending right there on the point. So it's a little bit, we had a little bit high with the clipper when you ran that under there, whoever did that or whatever, run it up on the back. But it's blending in right there. Okay. Just a little bit. Just to the point I could blend it. Okay. Okay. Let's get in here and work a little bit. Okay. Let's see if we can do something with it. Let me blend this a little bit more. I'll be with you in a minute, Frankie.
All right, Mark. Where'd you find that little camper at?
I got that from over at Jimmy Thompson had that camper.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Dolly?
Yeah, Jimmy Thompson had that camper. I bought it from him.
I saw that camper sitting around
there.
Yeah. So you bought it?
Oh, yeah.
At this point, we're getting a private haircut.
Well, we're doing a video, yeah. You on the video?
Oh,
it's all.
I broke the camera.
Making it big times. Might want you down there in New York, there in New York or something, you never know. What's over with? It's about the first video I've made this week, I think. Most of them I make two or three a day sometimes, but I was so busy yesterday I didn't want to take time to even do anything. I think I did 25 haircuts yesterday. 24 or 5. Come up to this point from here being shorter because we had to bring it actually shorter to get a nice spiky look, kind of. So, should give me something I could work with by you getting it off there. Give you a little different look than we've been doing. proper way to use thinning shears is after you finish with the cut, pretty much thin. Now, I know sometimes I go the other way, I'll thin a little bit to start with sometimes, but really, when you're about finished with cutting it with the shears, going with thinning shears afterwards. And let's go over here now. Just kind of do a little something here. Just kind of go this out. And it's pretty thick right in there. Lose the looks of my haircut. Hairstyle. Proper way always is to go under the hair too, like if it's going back, to go underneath it, of course, y'all know that. You go on top of the hair, you're leaving it, you're gonna have some gaps. There's one guy that's one of the best barbers I know of, but he thinned an excessive amount, and his haircuts really look good, perfect on the outside, but if I cut that haircut behind his after he thinned it 4 or 5 weeks before that, or 6 weeks, and I cut it like this, I got all kind of gaps. Look what Mike did to my hair, gapped my hair up. But no, I just uncovered the thinning. The man just took big chunks out. I don't know what he did so much, but his haircuts look great. But he just thinned a little bit more than I thought he should have. But he had a great looking haircut. And when I cut back over, it was like it was sabotaged, that haircut was. It was booby trapped, almost. The next person to cut behind us, they cut the length off. It uncovered all those gaps and it made you look bad, you know. I mean, I'm sure they said Mike just can't cut hair, man. But I uncovered what he did. He said, he's a great barber, though. And his haircuts look extremely good. But he just thinned so much, you know. Even now, I'm basically finished with this haircut, but I'm gonna need to come back in. And I'm gonna make sure I've got it blended. And when she blow dries it, when she fixes it, she's not gonna have any trouble with it. You got to be a little bit compulsive in the haircut and business to really do good work, I think. Just go back over it and over it to really get it smooth. Of course, you got to have enough time to do it, but you don't want to take too much time. There's one guy here in Sherall, around the county, he took an hour on every haircut he did. It always took an hour, and it did me too, but I talked so much the whole time when I first started that that's why it took me an hour. I was stopping and talking too much. But he takes an hour every haircut, and that means you can cut about 8 haircuts a day. I mean, and a lot of these video haircuts on the video, I'm taking 20 or 30 minutes on, and longer. I could do them a lot faster, but I'm trying to demonstrate. And I've got to actually bring that next side as short as this is, so let me look in the mirror. A little bit longer over here. That side was just a little bit shorter.
I reckon they got to aggravate you too, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Don't want to pick up the wrong shears when you do this haircut either. You got the regular shears and you're going to be in a mess. You got to take up a hair to work, head work with. I really enjoy cutting your hair too, man. I think it's easy to work with. Get some jiggle. Put a little product on there, as the high class folks say. Subscribe to our videos. We're going to be doing a lot of different cuts here. You may notice I do a lot of singing on there, write songs, a lot of songs. Most of the haircut, a lot of the men's haircut and flat tops and things. Probably might help you a little bit. A lot of these women cuts, short type cuts, and the longer cuts. Subscribe to us so if you enjoy it, enjoy what you're seeing. Kind of satisfied with it. It's a little bit different. Okay. I
like the looks of it. Appreciate you gonna let me do it. Let's look at this a little bit. Let's flip this thing around. Okay. Something a little different. Had to kind of bring it up because of the length it was, and it's kind of spiky a little bit. And kind of happy with it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thanks for watching, folks. Please subscribe to our channel. Let me duster just a little bit. Show my new duster, my paintbrush. Boy, that thing works good. See, that's what you need to get out and get you a paintbrush if you want a good duster. Okay. Thanks, folks. We'll see you.